In today's video, we're going to take this tree stump that we have here and we're going to retopologize it, where we very quickly go from this to this, where we have a completed retopologized mesh. Watch on to find out how to do it. Okay, so before I get started, I'm just going to mention that the kids are sleeping next door, so I've got to keep it quite quiet at the moment. I'll try and improve the sound in recording and see how we get on. Now, I've got this basic sculpt of a tree stump that I've done. Very simple, very basic, just took about 15 minutes or something, just for the purposes of this tutorial. What I'm going to do is I'm going to bring that into the layout, and it's here that we can now talk about the Polybuild tool and how you use it. The purpose of the Polybuild tool, which is a new custom tool that's been included in Blender, is so that you can take high poly meshes like this and produce the lower poly version through a process called retopology. It is like most of the tools we're covering at the moment in edit mode. However, before we get started, here's how you use it. The first thing we need to do is we need to create our first poly, basically. A very simple way to do that is do our usual, where we go in and we add a plane. So we have that to start with. The next thing to do is to get this to a reasonable size and position. I am going to rotate this. Snapping is already on. I'm just going to rotate that something like 90 degrees. And then I'm going to move it forward a little bit. I think we can start there. That's fine. Then I'm going to turn snapping off now. I'm going to scale it down. Then let's have it somewhere here to begin with. So we've got it in front of our mesh. The next thing that I need to do, I need to get my snapping right. And the reason for that is that as we retopologize this mesh, we're going to use snapping to be able to have our polys stick to both the faces and the vertices of this mesh. So first of all, go up to your snapping settings here and choose vertex, but also shift left click face. So it now says mix, and it means you've got both of those selected. There's various other snapping options that you can choose as well. Closest is fine, because it's simply going to be closest to the target, which for us is the mesh we're dealing with. The next thing that you want to actually have on is not there. Brilliant. I was being a numpty. So it's at this point, once you've done those snapping settings, then want to go into edit mode, then go back to snapping. You have this, it's already ticked here, but it says project onto self, and that basically makes sure also that your polys stick to as close to the surface of your sculpt as possible. We're now at a point that we can start using the Polybuild tool. The next thing you need to do is very simply click on the Polybuild tool here, or you can press shift spacebar to turn it on, which is the shortcut key, and then you can start using the tool. So the first thing to realize is that with the polygon that you've got selected, if you hover over an edge, you get a blue line. And if you hover over a vertice, don't know if you can see that, but you get a little blue dot. And all you have to do is hover the mouse cursor over a blue line and left mouse click and pull it out like this. And what you'll actually find is that with snapping turned on, it will actually stick or try and get as close as it can to the surface of the mesh. And then what else you can do is just keep pulling out like this as you go around your mesh, just pulling them out, and as you'll see, that just sticks as close as it can to the surface. Now onto the vertices. The good thing about the vertices is you can just click them and drag them like that, and again they will stick to various parts of faces or the surface as you pull them out, okay? And that's really powerful for repositioning your retopoed mesh. So if we pull this out here, see that It's actually starting to get a little bit stuck in the mesh there, so we can reposition the vertices in a way that perhaps makes a little bit more sense. Now, it's often a good idea to use transparency and to also have both your plane and your sculpt, in my case this tree stump, to be slightly different colors, because it just makes everything easier to see. So don't forget to select your tree stump and just change the color of it somehow. So, you know, we could go for, I think, maybe something like that, you know, which may work fine for our tree stump just for the moment. I'm going to go to my plane and I'm actually going to give it a different material. I'm going to give it that material for the moment. And then when I need to select vertices, I also make sure I turn transparency on when I need to do that. So once I go into edit mode, I can see them. One tool that you should always use with the Polybuild tool is AutoMerge, because it becomes very useful as you start to quickly build out your retopology. And I'll show you what I mean. So I'm pulling out these new faces, I'm repositioning vertices, trying to get them into a position where I think it could fit quite well. Okay, when you have the Polybuild tool selected, remember, you always have a tool panel up here. So if you click that open, got item, tool and view. It's already on tool for me. And you have a number of options. And down here is auto merge. If you have that on, when these vertices get close enough, they'll snap together. Now, it is at a threshold of 1 millimeter. And so based on the units I have here, which is a little big, I'm actually going to increase it. You may not need to. It depends on the scale you have set up in your scene. If you're working in centimeters, you'll probably find this is fine. I haven't changed mine for the purpose of this tutorial. I'm actually going to increase mine to 0.1, which is quite high, but it's just so I can do this quite quickly. So when I move those vertices closer together, they just bind. Then I can pull things out. As you can see, as I retopologise here, everything is binding together quite nicely. The last thing that I'll leave you with is that what you may not know about the Polybuild tool is that it is essentially a repurposing of an existing tool in Blender that we've already covered in an earlier video, which is a form of extrude, and that is extrude to cursor. I'll show you what I mean. I select this edge, come to extrude, and I select extrude to cursor. I can literally just press E and just keep going like that. Okay, let's do the underneath of this here. And some people may prefer to retopologize using that tool. There's a link in the description which talks about that tool and where you can use it, and more importantly, perhaps where you shouldn't use it. I really should clean those up right about now. So this is the retopologized mesh, and this is the sculpt that we've done. And as you can see, when they're together, it's a fairly close match. It's not exact, but you know, for tutorial purposes, I think it demonstrates the point. This is obviously not thick enough at all in this area, and these edges up here are clearly far too thick, as you can see. They would need to be brought down, something like that, perhaps. Still, hopefully you've learned something. That's how you use the Polybuild tool to retopologize meshes in Blender. If you learned something, give it a thumbs up. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Thank you.